I appreciate you guys watching this video. Thanks for tuning in. Making it work. Jimmy. Just so you know, this guy's Jimmy. This is making it work. Some funny stories. You want to hear about the time that my boss came in on a Saturday one time. I had the keys to the shop after I worked there about, 8 or 10 months. They gave me the keys to the shop so I could do side work or work on my own stuff or family members' cars. The boss was pretty cool. Of course, in the 80s, you know, people weren't as worried about liability and stuff like that. But on a Saturday, I was in the shop and I had my 55 Chevy, which had a 51 Studebaker pickup truck, I-beam axle in the front, real primitive. And whoever had put the suspension in the car, I guess they use it for drag racing or whatever, but they welded the shackles on the springs on both sides, front and back. They welded the shackles to the frame and took all the factory suspension arm mounts and stuff off the frame to lighten it, I guess. But the suspension didn't work because the shackles were welded front and rear, so the springs can't move. They could have just welded struts on top of the I-beam. Really not a good setup. Even at 19 years old, I think I was 19 or 20 when I had that car, I knew that that wasn't going to work. So I found a 56 Chevy four-door sedan, which the frames are the same, 55, 56, and 57. The frames are the same for two doors and four doors and Nomads. They're all the same frame. The only frame that was different was a convertible. I think it had more bracing in a convertible, but other than that, they were all the same frame. So anyway, I bought this 56 four-door. I think I paid $175 for that car. And then because it had no front end on, it was a 56 four-door body on a rolling chassis, and I just wanted the chassis. I towed that to the shop and started on a Friday night. On Saturday, my boss came in, and I had both cars in front of the bay doors, and my 55 Chevy was up on jack stands, and I was rolling the frame out from that one. And my boss pulled up to get gas because he was going to his ski lodge in Vermont. And he said, "What are you doing?" I had both cars blown apart, frames and stuff in the parking lot in the two cars. And we were selling gas. There was somebody there working the gas pump separate. You know, the shop wasn't open after 2 o'clock on Saturday. So I started at 2 o'clock on these cars. So he came back around 4 or 5 o'clock to get gas to go up to his lodge and saw what I was doing. He was like, "What are you doing?" And I said, "I'm changing my frame." I didn't think it was a big deal. So I literally took the wheels off and I put the lug nuts on the drums to hold the drums on. And I used them to roll the frame. All by myself, I rolled the frame out from one, rolled it out from the other. And then I lifted the frame on a jack. I kind of lifted it and steered it with a jack across to the other car. I had them right next to each other behind the bays. And I rolled the frame over behind the 55, the good frame, and I pushed it up on the brake drums underneath the car. And then I lowered the car down with the, I pushed it up underneath the car and it barely cleared because I had to have the car as high as the jack stands would take it. And the frame barely went underneath. And then I used the floor jack and I jacked the frame up in the front, and I used the second floor jack in the back, and I got the body mount bolt started and just got it so it was pretty close. And then I put the wheels back on and had a friend help me push the car back into the shop, lifted it on the lift and started tightening all the bolts and putting things back together and put my engine and transmission in, and that basically I got the frame bolted up and got the engine and transmission back in the car by Saturday night at about midnight. I was hoping to get it running that night, but I was pretty ambitious, but I wasn't realistic. Pretty typical for a 19 or 20 year old, so. But that was fun. My boss was just like, "What are you doing?" Just one of the stories. I got a whole bunch more of them, but we'll do them in a separate video. I'll make a video for some of the things that I remember from my youth. Some of the things that I built so many cars and did so many things like that, you know. It's just amazing how much stuff I've done. And back then, I didn't realize it was supposed to be hard. I just thought you wanted to do it, so you did it. I didn't realize you were supposed to have training and experience, and you had to worry about safety and all those things. And I never got hurt. I was always pretty safe without realizing. I was taking precautions, not knowing that this was what people were taught to do. I never dropped a car or did anything really bad like that. In all my experiences with building all these cars and engines, and I mean, I was constantly buying cars with blown up engines and fixing them up to resell them. So, but I'll make some videos about all that stuff. Take a look for those. I'll try to do a couple of those every month or so. I'll put up a couple of videos that are just stories about my youthful exuberance when I was in my teens and 20s doing some crazy stuff that people would consider impossible today or wouldn't even want to attempt. Some of the younger guys today, I mean, a lot of YouTube videos I see, the younger guys want to pretend they're way smarter than the older guys, and they discredit the older guys. Ah, that cranky old bastard don't know anything. But I mean, they weren't around, you know, sniffing gasoline and pumping gas for everybody back in the day and putting engines in cars on their back without lifts and stuff, and some of the things that we did back then. Things are a little different nowadays. I think you guys will find some of them stories pretty entertaining. So anyway, I appreciate you guys watching. Jimmy making it work, because that's what I'm always doing in some form or another, whether it's at home, at work, all kind of, I'm always trying to get something working. Make sure you like and subscribe if you haven't yet. I hope you're done with that number two and you didn't get chafed or anything like that. So see you guys in the next video.